Why the Ottoman Empire was called the sick man of Europe? If you are interested in knowing the answer, then keep watching. Sick man of Europe is a label given to European country who is experiencing economic difficulties. The term was first used in the mid-19th century to describe the Ottoman Empire, but has since applied at one time or another to nearly every other major country in Europe. Ottoman Empire was created by Turkish tribes in Anatolia, which later became one of the most powerful states in the world during the 15th and 16th centuries. The Ottoman period spanned more than 600 years and came to an end only in 1922 when it was replaced by the Turkish Republic and various successor states in southeastern Europe and the Middle East. At its height, the empire encompassed most of the southeastern Europe to the gates of Vienna, including present-day Hungary, the Balkan region, Greece and parts of Ukraine, portions of the Middle East now occupied by Iraq, Syria, Israel and Egypt, North Africa as far as Algeria and large parts of the Arabian Peninsula. The term Ottoman is a dynastic appellation derived from Usman I, the nomadic Turkmen chief who founded both the dynasty and the empire. From the beginning of the 18th century onward, the Ottoman Empire went into a steady decline. By mid-18th century, that decline accelerated, and by the beginning of 19th century, it was incapable of defending itself. It was incapable of even holding itself together. In the 19th century, a number of conquered peoples in the Ottoman Empire rebelled and achieved separation. Serbia, Greece, Bulgaria, Romania, they all achieved their statehood by separation from the Ottoman Empire. Egypt at the time also achieved de facto independence but was quickly turned into British protectorate. The Ottoman Empire was declining and its military power was heavily weakened due to repeated military defeats. The Ottoman Empire was also facing internal instability due to ethnic and religious conflicts. The empires of Great Britain and Austria-Hungary believed that the presence of Ottoman Empire preserved a delicate balance of power in Europe, while the Russian Empire stood to benefit from the fall of the Ottomans. This is commonly referred to as the Eastern Question. So, the Ottoman Empire was called the sick man of Europe because it was incapable of defending itself, it was even incapable of holding itself together, and it was only kept alive because other countries prevented each other from attacking it. It is not easy to determine the actual source of the quotation, but most probably this was a quotation from the Tsar Nicholas I mocking about the relative backwardness of the Ottoman Empire at that time compared to the most eastern countries including Russia. The fate of the Ottoman Empire had been in question ever since the Russo-Turkish War and was finalized after the World War I with the defeat and dissolution of the Ottoman Empire. In 1854, British Ambassador G.H. Seymour, in a private conversation, had to push the Tsar to be more specific about the Ottoman Empire. Eventually, the Tsar stated, "Turkey seems to be falling to pieces. The fall will be a great misfortune. It is very important that the England and Russia should come to a perfectly good understanding and that neither should take any decisive step of which the other is not apprised." And then closer to the attributed phrase, "We have a sick man on our hand, a man gravely ill. It will be a great misfortune if one of these days he slips through our hands, especially before the necessary arrangements are made." The sick man eventually collapsed after defeat in the Middle Eastern theater of World War I.
يلومونني في اشتهاء الحياة وأني للذاتها أرتوي وأني بها مغرم عاشق وقلبي